First of all, I will explain about the background of the company. Axiata Group Berhad, which formerly known as a TM International Berhad, was incorporated in 1992 as an international business division of Telekom Malaysia. Before it became the listed company, it was only operated as the mobile and international arm for Telekom Malaysia Berhad. In the year of 2008, it demerged, or in other words, we call separated with Telekom Malaysia and become a listed company, and as which is Axiata was listed on the main board of Bursa Saham Malaysia. On the subsequent year, Axiata came out with a new logo in March 2009. After it changed their name and its logo, Axiata started its new journey with a new commitment, which is to fulfill the unsatisfied communication needs of human with reasonable and advanced digital products and services. Axiata Group Berhad own 290 million subscribers in 10 countries and offers various telecommunication services and mobiles. According to annual report of Axiata in 2016, Axiata has widened its presence to another country, which is make it 11 countries of subscriber, which is the new one in 2016 is Myanmar. For advancing Asia, Axiata Group always adapt quickly with changing to take advantage in the development of the digital world over across the world. Beside that, there are three types of business that Axiata Group Berhad runs. It is a digital telco, digital business and digital infrastructure. Digital telco, which is as we know about Celcom Expect, and then we have digital business such as e-wallet, Boost app, cashless mobile payment, and then we have a digital infrastructure. For digital infrastructure is edotco. I want to highlight this company. It is a new business unit for Axiata Group Berhad, which established in 2012. This group is specialized is in end-to-end solution tower service sector, including core location, build to suit, transmission and operation and maintenance. It is operating in to 6 countries and offers various telecommunication and infrastructure services. This infrastructure company has accumulated more than 16,000 towers and 12,000 kilometers of optical fibers for the purpose to being one of the top local tower organization and focus on operate as responsible and sustainable development of enterprise. Okay, next, Axiata also was awarded the Frost and Sullivan's Award in 2009, 2010, 2011 and 2012, which the award for being best telecom group and the Telecom Asia Best Regional Mobile Group. Also in 2016, edotco first received recognition from Frost and Sullivan as the Southeast Asia Telecom Tower Company of the Year. Furthermore, in 2019 annual report of Axiata Group Berhad, Khazanah Nasional and other state funds such as Permodalan Nasional Berhad and Employee Provident Fund EPF, which combine hold more than 70% of Axiata shares. While recently on February 2019, Axiata sold off its entire shares to the Connectivity Limited Company for RM 1.65 billion. The reason of need to sell their shares is to reallocation capitals and new priorities in line with the visions to make Axiata to become the next generation digital champion by 2022.
Assalamualaikum to Madam Noraida and my fellow classmates. My name is Nur Adila Nordin, and today I will be presenting to you all on the classifications of risk at Axiata. The first risk is financial risk, which refers to the uncertainty of loss because of adverse changes in commodity prices, interest rates, foreign exchange rates, and the values of money. At Axiata, they are exposed to foreign currency exchange volatilities, which affect the group cash flows and financial performance. The group has borrowings in foreign currencies and is aware of the foreign exchange and interest rate exposures. Volatility exchange rates make international trade and investment decision more difficult because volatility increases exchange rate risk. Hence, to manage this risk, Axiata Treasury Management Center has been tasked to oversee and control the group treasuries and funding matters, taking into consideration the current and future outlook of the relevant economies and foreign exchange markets, with the ultimate objective of preserving the group's profitability and sustainability. Moving on to the next risk is operational risk, which refers to the uncertainties and hazards a company adopts when doing its business activities. At Axiata, the group relies on third-party vendors in many aspects of its business. For example, the telecom industry is influenced by a handful of vendors, which means that when there are loss of supply due to a key vendor, it can affect the business to fail and significantly affect the core business and operations. Therefore, to manage the risk, Axiata Procurement Center's key role is to be on the lookout for ways to manage this risk by monitoring the performance of the vendors and developing new relationships to reduce such dependencies. Thank you. That is all from me. Moving on to the next risk, which is strategic risk, which refers to the uncertainty regarding the firm's financial goals and objective. At Axiata, they found out that it was challenging to keep up with the changing of consumer expectation and competitive pricing, as the evolution of telecoms landscape has created a change in customer expectations away from simple connectivity to customers wanting better experience in internet connection, network quality, and competitive tariff rates. Therefore, to manage this risk, Axiata has taken close monitors on the competitive landscape to explore and make appropriate investment to upgrade its technology and platforms and review the relevancy of its product and service offerings in order to stay in track with other telco. Thank you. That is all from me. Overall, there are 11 categories of key risk areas in the Axiata Group Berhad, which are financial risk, market risk, regulatory risk, cybersecurity and data privacy risk, digital risk, operational risk, geopolitical risk, strategic and investment risk, people risk, technology risk, and finally governance and integrity risk. Thank you. That is all from me. Moving on to the next slide, which discusses on the enterprise risk management of Axiata. They adopt the Axiata Enterprise Risk Management Framework as a standardized approach for timely identification, reporting, and management of principal business risks and ensures implementation, tracking, and review of effectiveness on managing the risks identified. Secondly, Axiata uses an integrated assurance methodology to manage their material risk, which focuses on risk identifications along with the group's exposure and potential impact. Third, the Axiata Enterprise Risk Management function is to provide an integrated focus on all and compliance matter directly and indirectly, a single consistent interface with all other functions in the organization and in OpCos. Thank you. That is all from me.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good day to Madam Nuraida and my fellow friends. My name is Siti Fatimah. So next, I will proceed with risk assessment and risk response at Axiata Group Berhad. As for risk assessment, the board engaged the services with KPMG Management and Risk Consulting Sdn Bhd to assist with the 2019 evaluation of board performance for the company. For your information, KPMG is a corporate governance advisory firm that specializes in facilitating board reviews. First and foremost, board members were invited to complete a questionnaire and selected board members were invited to participate in interviews. The findings of the 2019 board effectiveness and evaluation have recommended areas for improvement in risk assessment. Firstly is the need for focused education and development program on company-specific issues that it is for training that aligned with Axiata strategies. Then the qualitative audits need to be considered on its operating companies for inspecting similar adoption for the group's ethical and compliance culture. It is also for the transformational efforts on improving Axiata's company's performance. Lastly, detailed feasibility studies and country analysis operations and businesses should be considered on conducting it more, as it affects for the long-term performance of Axiata Group Berhad. As for risk response of Axiata Group Berhad, the findings of 2019 board effectiveness and evaluation, Axiata board's commitment and resilience remain a distinct personality within the market comparators. This is because Axiata's strategy planning remains a reverberating flag team for Axiata, which akin to other comparators. Also, the efficacy of the board chairman and high concentration of independent directors have led to a continuity of full throttle deliberations amongst board members. Hence, the collaborative working relationship between the board and the managing director, president and group chief executive officer GCEO continues to be a standout feature for Axiata, with the GCEO being an effective bridge between management and the board. The board of Axiata remains a dedicated and collective unit with independent thought, which are clearly shown through the board's devotion for long hours and proximate involvement in overseeing the proposed Axiata-Telenor merger. Hence, the board's clear succession model, known as the phased retirement plan, is a novel market practice amongst peers both locally and globally, which allow the board composition to be revitalized. Lastly, the succession planning for the GCEO, Group Chief Executive Officer, was crafted since 2014 through a methodical and well-thought-out succession plan, which involved a series of well-crafted strategies, including implementing shortlisted candidates to the board. That's all from me. Thank you.
Basically, the board is primarily responsible for ensuring sound risk management procedure and internal control activity to protect the investment of shareholder and also the property of the company. The system includes not just financial regulation but also organizational and regulatory controls. Board Risk and Compliance Committee BRCC, which now formally as a Board Risk Management Committee BRMC, was formed with effect from 1st January 2018. BRCC rules and obligations cover the field of corporate risk management, which including organizational resilience and disaster management, cyber protection, data safety, ethical and honesty enforcement, and regulatory compliance, which include but are not restricted to conditions levied by the financial market body, the central market. For example, such as e-money, forex control and more. The benefit of the BFCC, which consists of the Board of Independent Non-Executive Director, INED, is to have the President and CGEO as well as the Board Representative of the main operating companies, OPCOS, as participants. From 1st January of 2018, Axiata has set up a Board Risk Management Committee, BRMC, in accordance with the proposal of the Malaysian Code of Corporate Governance 2017 to regulate the company risk management system and policies. The BRMC main function is to give direction of Axiata Group's enterprise risk, undertaking risk management system, assessing the effectiveness of these practices, establishment of proper of risk management strategies and business continuous governance. Meanwhile, on 20 February 2020, the name of the BRMC has been resolved into the Board Risk and Compliance Committee BRCC by board. This change was to develop reflection in the widen of the to the scope of the committee to surround not only just in terms of risk but in terms of audience as well. Under authorized of Board Risk Management Committee BRMC, Axiata Group Berhad Board implement the Cybersecurity Steering Committee CSCC as a subcommittee of the BRMC. This subcommittee is established to help the BRMC in focus on adopting network protection policy that assure that the application of the practices around the Axiata Group. In addition, CSCC also focus on approach was necessary with a range of cyber attacks and the level of intensity faced by each of these attacks, the organization all over the country. In August 2019, the CSSC was disbanded due to the extension of the scope of CSSC. The CSSC was largely responsible for cybersecurity concerns and in recognition of the value of data protection. The Committee of Expanded Jurisdiction Data Protection and Computer Security is expected to be discussed. All in all, it is clearly that Board Risk Management Committee, BRMC or BRCC, as an effective and efficient risk governance model for Axiata Group from 2018 until present. Hence, Board also did the great job as well as they are responsible to protect the risk related with the data protection and cybersecurity and to achieve their objective successfully. And their implementation by them is also able giving big impact to Axiata Group either in external or internal.
Proceed to suggestion for the improvement for risk management practices. Why organization should think to improve risk management? Because as generally is to provide the discipline and control to ensure that risk management capability are improved continuously and in a constantly changing business environment and to increase ability to anticipate unexpected event, which is getting prepared for the worst one instead of taking easy about it without worry. Also, the main is to define and execute strategies to prevent and reduce risk. What is enhancing the risk management activity of Axiata Group Berhad? First, communication and consultation. As one of ASEAN leading telecommunication group, must make communication and consultation their organization priority. In life, job and relationship, strong communication skills are the key to success. Communication is the process by which we exchange information between individual or group of individuals. It is a process where they try as clearly and accurately as they will to convey their thoughts, intention, and objective. Without viable correspondence, a message can fall into mistake, misconception, disappointment, and inaccurate by being confused or indefinite. Formal internet communication channel should be set up and all data that related with the risk management should be delivered and shown to all staff, particularly the individual who are straightforwardly or by implication associated with the risk management process. When company practice the most effective tends to communicate, it can reduce unnecessary competition within department and help employees work together harmoniously. The result of a team that work together is high productivity, honesty, and efficiency. Employees understand their team responsibility and recognize they are respected. Besides that, monitoring is that the ongoing process of regularly collecting and analyzing relevant information to form sure you are doing what you commence to try and do. It tends to happen continuously, but set of knowledge could also be gathered together at regular intervals, as an example quarterly. Review is after you examine the result of an evaluation and judge whether it must change. Information from monitoring might also prompt a review of little area of your work, but considerable review can apply occur once a correct evaluation of your effectiveness has taken place. Review may happen annually or at the top of an extended term project. So, Axiata company adapt this process and increase the capability in order to nothing to miss out. Anything daily important, thing such as the information that relate to their system like digital system, operational system, data privacy, and their documentation. This process is to ensure that the predetermined administration activity plans stay updates and refresh, also nothing left behind. Lastly but not least, risk management tool, technique and framework should be used to carry out the risk management process and all exercise relate to identifying, implementing, reviewing, and evaluating and continuous improvement of the risk management framework. For example, use of the risk dashboard, template of the layout, monitoring sheet, risk management data framework. As a Axiata company, there have been practices the various tools such as overdue brainstorming among the employees in order to clarify or identify what problem that has been occurred and come up with a good solution, also with consensus among them. Moreover, an organization should upgrade their technology, especially the Axiata company, which is as one of the leading telecommunication group in Asia. When company upgrade their technology, technique, or tools, it can make the business run effectively, accurately, smoothly, so that if any obstacle appear in organization, the rate of risk happen is low, because when a company provide or improve their system, it can make the way an organization handle it with a zest and competence. As a conclusion, all organizations will face the risk and it cannot be avoided, but surely it can make risk happen is low when company adapt or improve every single opportunity that can make organization run in better place. That's all from me. Thank you.
Conclusion: every organization should prepare for the unexpected with a risk management strategy, mitigating risk and any additional cost before they happen. Organization need to provide enterprise risk management framework, and it is important to establish an ERM framework in the business because it will enable a firm to gain a clear view of its overall risk level. They will save money and secured the future of the company by considering possible threat or incident before they happen by having a risk management plan. The organization should look at the necessary action to prevent the loss occurring, limit the damage that event could cause, and also to contain the cost of recovering from the event. Axiata Group Berhad adopts ERM framework as a standardized approach. Axiata ERM continuously address issues such as network congestion, drops calls, and upgrade to network coverage to ensure better quality network and service is delivered while lowering the risk of losing the customer. Axiata will ensure proactive measures are taken to facilitate dealing with the risk within the company that can bring down the company and having a significant impact into the industry. As a proof, until today, Axiata still survive in the industry, remain stable in the Bursa Saham Malaysia, and has always been a successful company in Malaysia and also across the Asia. Thank you, that's all.